As a vegetable gardener, I'm always looking for ways to boost my garden's fertility and produce an abundance of food. And with a vast array of fertilisers like fish emulsions, seaweed, synthetics, manure, and many, many more, it's tempting to think that the key to rich, productive soil lies in these products. But what if I told you that the real secret to a productive garden wasn't in a bottle or a bag, but in its very design? In this episode, we'll dig into the science of how plant diversity is key to fertile soil, and how permaculture design can transform your garden's productivity. Plus, I'll show you the practical ways that I'm building diversity into my own backyard this spring. Back in 2009, there was a study published from an ongoing biodiversity experiment in a small town called Jena in Germany. In this study, they tested how plant diversity compared to fertilizer in increasing overall plant yield. They had 78 different plots where they combined different numbers of plant species and different levels of fertilizer applications. What their results showed was that in both years, higher diversity was more effective in increasing productivity than higher management intensity, meaning more fertilizer. Interestingly, what they also found was that the more different the plants were, the better the plot performed. In other words, combining a legume, a grass, a short herb, and a tall herb was more productive than combining five different types of grasses. And if you think about it, this is what Mother Nature does if left to her own devices. Like this vacant lot here next to my house, where I've counted at least 15 different species. In a similar study in Ireland, they found that five species grown together produced twice as much biomass as a monoculture. And that monoculture had to be given 360 kilograms of nitrogen per hectare to be able to produce more biomass than that five species mix without fertilizer. But why? Why is diversity proving to have such a positive effect on productivity? Well, a partial explanation might be that different plants are shaped differently, and so they can occupy the space that others don't use, both above and below ground, without too much competition. Another contributing factor might be that a diversity of plants attracts a diversity of insects, creating a better balance of pests and predators. But what these factors don't explain is the increased vigor and vitality of the plants in the multi-species crops. I think the biggest contributing factor is the positive effect that plant diversity has on the presence of fungi in the soil. Certain types of fungi, called mycorrhizal fungi, can form symbiotic relationships with plants where they deliver them nutrients from the soil and allow nutrients and information to be shared between plants. This is referred to as a common mycorrhizal network, and it can provide plants with up to 90% of their nitrogen and phosphorus requirements. So given what this science shows, I think it's worth considering how we can use plant diversity to fertilize our gardens for free. Because if you've got a vegetable garden, then you're probably already growing quite a few different kinds of plants. And so all we need to do is think about how we arrange them, such that we're putting dissimilar plants together. In permaculture, we call a diverse group of plants a guild. And this in part draws on the knowledge of indigenous cultures, who have long recognized the benefits of diversity. One well-known example used by indigenous Americans is the Three Sisters, which is corn, squash, and beans. But there are so many creative ways that you can combine crops. Over the past 2 years, I've been experimenting with my own different combinations, usually involving 2 to 4 crops. In a minute, I'm gonna show you some new guilds that I'm planning for this spring. But first, my next video is gonna be about how I start all my crops from seeds using a foolproof method. So if you wanna make sure that you don't miss that, then hit subscribe and also hit the notification bell. I've just finished my garden plan for spring and summer, so I'm gonna show you some of the guilds that I've come up with that I think are quite interesting. The first one that I'm excited about is Jerusalem artichokes, sunflowers, and beans. I've never grown Jerusalem artichokes before, but from what I can tell, they grow quite tall and bushy, but not quite as tall as sunflowers, so I'm hoping that I can put the sunflowers in the middle and they'll poke up the top. The bush beans I think I'll plant around the outside of the bed because they're quite short. Another guild that I think will work well is tomatoes, fennel, beets, and spring onion. Tomatoes go in a row in the middle and get trellised, and then the fennel, spring onion, and beets will go on either side of the tomato rows. Spring onions are a great crop to add diversity to pretty much any bed because they squeeze in between so many plants so easily. Here are some things to consider if you're planning to design some of your own guilds. So first, think about how your plants are going to fit together spatially. Is one plant going to overshadow another? And how are you going to arrange them in the bed? Are you going to arrange them in rows or blocks or just scatter them throughout? And then in terms of harvesting, are you going to have to reach over one plant to get to another? Is one going to need to be trellised? Or are any of the plants perennials that are going to stick around for more than 1 year? There is so much creativity that can be had in designing plant guilds, but seriously, don't worry if that's overwhelming. You can start super simply just by picking a couple of species like lettuce and spring onions, sticking them in the ground and seeing how they do. So I hope this video has helped you rethink the role of fertilizer by showing you how you can increase the productivity of your garden just through permaculture design. Now, don't throw away your fish emulsion and your rock dust. I'm not saying these can't be useful tools, but as we've seen through science and nature, plant diversity is a fundamental part of building soil fertility.